Morning, Carlton. Today is Monday, November 9th. I'm Evan Walker.
I'm Maggie Morgan.
I'm Bailey Vetter.
I'm Zach Holderbaum.
I'm Sean Hart.
And I'm Jenna Hunt. Let's begin with the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. All right. Last Thursday was the first face-to-face instruction for students at the junior-senior high school since Friday, March 13th. The school day went smoothly with students following social distance and safety guidelines. We'd like to take a moment to remind students about the importance of washing your hands often to stop the spread of germs. Let's take a look at a special video made with the help of Gwen Calamon and Lucas Propelka.
Hello and thank you for being part of our Carlton School District family. I'm Brad Langerman with Steritor Sanitary Supply Company. We provide many of the cleaning and restroom items used in your district. Joining me are students.
Gwen Calamon, I'm a junior here at Carlton, captain of the color guard, member of the cross country team and soccer team.
And I'm Lucas Pribolka, and I'm a junior at Carlton as well, and I'm a captain on the soccer team.
In the following segment, we're going to discuss the importance of proper hand washing. With the continued concern over the spread of coronavirus, COVID-19, as well as seasonal flu, respiratory ailments, or the common cold, staying healthy and preventing others from getting sick is a shared responsibility of everyone in our district. Germs can spread surface to person to person, or through droplets in the air. According to the Center for Disease Control, good hand washing is still the most important thing we can do to stop the spread of infection. You can help yourself stay healthy by washing your hands often and properly. As we look forward to returning to school, our main priority is to keep our students and staff safe and healthy. Here are some times during the school day that we should try to wash our hands. Shortly after arriving to school in the morning,
before we leave the afternoon,
before eating lunch, as germs can spread from hands to food. When hands are soiled, such as after cleaning, playing a sport, or working on a project.
And after using the restroom.
Wash hands after using shared electronics, such as computers or any high-touch surface. After coughing or sneezing, but always remember, never cough or sneeze into your hand. Use your arm or elbow. At home, you should wash more if a family member is sick. And try not to touch your face too often unless your hands are clean. Germs can travel this way. For our Cougar student athletes, your efforts can allow us to play sports safely, but guidelines must be followed as outlined by your team coaches. Please follow this simple but proven infection control protocol throughout the season. Always wash your hands before practice and at the conclusion before leaving for home. Also, wash up before and after using weight room equipment. Wiping down equipment also helps eliminate germ spread.
Again, please be sure to follow all guidelines and for safety. And thanks for making us proud. Let's go to reporter Zach Holderbaum for more information.
Thanks, Jonah. The Carlington Athletics online store is now open, and it's just in time for fall weather. Look for hats, sweatshirts, long and short sleeve tees, sweatpants, and more. A link for the store will appear in the description of this video. All items have been designed specifically for Carlington, and there are lots to choose from. The store will remain open until the end of the day today to ensure that all orders can be filed before the Christmas holiday. Again, click on the link in the description of this video to order your items today before it's too late. All right, Bailey, tell us about how seniors can earn some money for college.
Okay, Zach, there are dozens of scholarships available to seniors, and if you're looking to earn some money toward college or career training, we've got just the thing for you. These include the Epilepsy Association Scholarship Program, the Foot Locker Scholarship for Student Athletes, the Berkshire Hathaway Scholarship, and many more. Again, for a complete list, check out the Guidance Google Classroom. Have questions? Contact Mrs. Gallagher for more information. Okay, Maggie, I hear you have some information for students.
That's right, Bailey. Attention seniors, it's been tradition for seniors and their siblings to be photographed together for the yearbook. We're looking to keep that tradition alive with the help of technology. Stay safe and stay together by sharing your favorite sibling photo with the yearbook. Use the Google form in the Google Classroom to submit your photo of you and your siblings. You can also find the link in the description of this video. Also, the yearbook wants to know all about what you've been up to during remote learning. Students in grades 7 through 12 are invited to complete the Google form in your guidance classroom to share any new hobbies, skills, interests, or knowledge you've picked up during the pandemic. Snap a picture and share it. Again, look for the link for the form in your guidance classroom in the description of this video. All right, let's go over to Sean with our next story.
You got it, Maggie. There are many seniors who are settling on plans for their future, and of course, this means requesting letters of recommendation and transcripts. Remember to always include your resume when asking a teacher or mentor to write a letter of recommendation for you. Also, be sure to clearly indicate the deadline when you must have this letter so that you aren't rushed. After receiving your letter, remember to send a quick thank you. Also, seniors, when requesting official Carlington transcripts, things just got a little easier. Look for the link in the Senior Guidance Classroom and complete the transcript request form. If you have any questions about this, contact Mrs. Gallagher for more information. Let's head over to Evan for more.
All right, so I'd like to wish a very happy birthday real quick to Linda Jo Everett in 8th grade and Brianna Lyle in 9th grade. Have a great day, Carlton.